Once this pipe cutter is properly placed, it's really easy to cut. I especially like the outcome of the edge, which is very clean and does not need aftercare. Today's mission: connect IBCs and filter tank. Use the plumbing set made from pipes and fittings to connect the two IBCs from the drains to the inlet of the filter tank. Tip: there will be water in the drain of the filled tank. Okay, let's see. We do not need the protection gear Conrad used last episode for using the diamond drill to create a hole in the aquarium glass of the filter tank. We also do not need the drill this time. Let's find the package the plumbing set was shipped in and select it as a tool. This is actually a set which you can order like this online, but it is for two IBCs stacked vertically on top of each other. I ordered this version because I need a T-joint fitting, which was not included in the horizontal set. Let's go! Let's build the contents of the box. We have got several pieces of pipe, a feed through for the filter tank and some connectors for the IBC drains, and of course some elbow and T-joint fittings. The water will flow out of the IBCs and into the filter tank, so the left IBC will get a 90 degree elbow and the second IBC will be connected to a T-joint at its drain. Another 90 degree elbow will change the pipe direction from horizontal to vertical, and the height is determined by the position of the feed through in the filter tank. The height of the hole there also sets the height of the water level. It is close to the 500 liter mark of the IBC and was specified last episode when I was drilling the hole into the aquarium glass. In order to connect the fittings, the protective lid cover needs to be removed from the drain. A reducer is then screwed onto the IBC drain. The 90 degree elbow piece can easily be connected to the reducer. We can already let it point into the direction the water will flow later, but it will need some adjustments. If we move over to the secondary IBC, which is already filled, we need to make sure the valve is closed before removing the drain cover. There will be a little amount of water between valve and cover from the previous APS 3 episode, where we installed a filter mesh on the inside of the IBC drain. After mounting the reducer to the drain, the T-joint can be twisted onto this thread. A piece of pipe connects the T-joint to the secondary 90 degree elbow, which changes the flow from horizontal to vertical. With the elbow in place, the vertical pipe can be installed. It needs to be cut to the right length, but before I do that, let's finish the horizontal plumbing first. For this, I just put the pipe into the T-joint and screw the cap tight. It will be necessary to cut the pipes into the right length. Let's assemble the fitting to the pipe to know how much of the pipe will reach inside and measure the distance after. About 6 cm of pipe will be inside the fitting, and if we add this amount to the pipe, it will be close to the length which we need. We cut the PVC pipe with this specialized clamp. It tightens around the pipe and will therefore tighten a circular blade, which will then cut into the plastic to release pressure if the clamp is rotated 360 degrees. Since there is no movement in the fittings, it's best to disconnect the drain connector, since its thread is not attached to the valve and can be tightened without rotating the piece itself. Let's work on the feed through at the glass now. We need to clean it first. Let's start with a broom. maybe better with a wet sponge. There's some debris from the drilling on the outside and some dried duckweed on the inside of the tank. After this is gone, let's wipe the glass dry with a towel. There's a seal ring on the feed through, so we will not use silicone for now. I just noticed I need a different part here since there are two male thread parts. After driving around town finding a proper fitting, I just ordered a female version of this part via Amazon, which just arrived. Now we only need to cut the vertical pipe into its right length and install a short horizontal pipe as inflow into the filter tank. I could have shorted the piece of pipe at the bottom in order to be more flexible with the piece of pipe going into the filter tank here, but the space is just large enough to fit a piece of pipe between both fittings. We can cut the vertical pipe now. Once this pipe cutter is properly placed, it's really easy to cut. I especially like the outcome of the edge, which is very clean and does not need aftercare. I like the quality of the parts and they also look clean. The set was quite easy to install and should be easy to maintain as well. I only wonder if the plumbing is a bit stiff, which means if there is some movement in the IBCs, it could translate into the glass and create tensions here. I wonder if it would be better to place some kind of flexible pipe or a hose instead of the injection molded and threaded pieces. I will keep this thought in my mind and see how this configuration ages. I might change it in the future, but for now I'll leave it as is. This concludes today's mission. Subscribe for the next episode and leave some feedback in the comments below. You could also check out this video.
Or if it's your birthday, maybe this one.
Hear that.